everyone, welcome to my channel As Told by Sinjini. I'm Sinjini and here I talk about books. So if you are a reader or if you wish to start reading, please make sure to subscribe. Also hit the bell icon so that you can get notified whenever I put up a new video. Today I'm going to talk about three novels with strong women characters. So without any further ado, let's get into it. Is A Thousand Splendid Sons by Khalid Hosseini. Maryam, the first female protagonist, was stigmatized right from the beginning because she was the illegitimate child of Jalil, a wealthy and powerful man, and his former servant Nana. Forced by her stepmothers and due to lack of opposition by his father, Maryam was married at a tender age to a much older man, Rashid, and was sent off to Kabul. Now, Maryam soon realized Rashid's controlling, dominating and abusive personality. After multiple miscarriages, she was turned into nothing but a burden in his home. Leila, the daughter of Maryam's neighbor and the second female protagonist, had a different sort of childhood because she had a relatively modern and liberal family. Although she did not go through any feminist development, Leila was raised in an atmosphere of equality. But when circumstances compelled her to marry Rashid, Leila was also subjected to a similar kind of physical brutality and oppression. Leila's entry in Maryam's life triggered her feminist consciousness. Leila's strong identity and values pushed Maryam to stand for herself as well as this other woman and her children who she gradually develops an affection for. This strong emotional connection between Maryam and Leila provided them the courage to endure and subsequently protest against the maltreatment of their husband and the tyranny that was going on in Afghanistan during that time. To see such a powerful and profound female friendship and sisterhood was quite refreshing. The second book is Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo by Taylor Jenkins Reid. The protagonist Evelyn was an interesting amalgamation of famous old Hollywood icons like Marilyn Monroe, Elizabeth Taylor, Audrey Hepburn, and Judy Garland. Evelyn is an incredibly complex character, and it is her flaws that make her so painfully real. She does not shy away from using her body and her sensuality to succeed in an industry that is externally glamorous but in actuality is quite discriminative and outright sexist. Evelyn Hugo is aware of her beauty and she is ready to make full use of it to make her own ends meet. It feels good to see a character like Evelyn, who is not a damsel in distress, who can fight for herself and who does not need any Prince Charming to save her from her circumstances. Evelyn does not regret any of her decisions, not even her marriages to seven different men. She leaves no stone unturned to reach the top and stay there, but that does not make her ruthless. She can also love with all her heart and make sacrifices for her closed ones. The last book is Sita's Sister by Kavita Kane. Now we all know the story of Ramayana, right? It explores the lives of Ram, Lakshman and Sita who were banished from their kingdom Ayodhya by an unwilling and helpless Dasharath for 14 years. It further shows how Sita was abducted by Ravan and how Ram and Lakshman, along with a brave Vanara army, rescued her and killed the mighty king of Lanka. Now, Ramayan had other characters too who were overshadowed due to the seemingly significant protagonists and antagonists. Kavita Kane tells us the story of one such character, Sita's sister and Lakshman's wife, Urmila. She was bold, passionate, knowledgeable, wise, curious, and capable of handling the most complex situations and enduring the most excruciating pains seamlessly. She was the real daughter of King Janaka and Queen Sunaina. No one really talks what happened to Urmila when her husband abandoned her to serve his brother. According to Kane, she was heartbroken, of course, but she did not sit in her room and cried. Rather, she utilized Lakshman's exile to gain a strong grasp over the Upanishads and Vedas and became a learned scholar. She also indulged in painting and pulled together the household, which fell apart when Ram, Sita and Lakshman left. Now, the ending of the book brings us to the beginning, where each of the wives of the Ayodhya's princes were predicted to lead painful lives. Now, we all know what became of Sita, but this book, Sita's Sister, offers us a closure about Urmila too. These three books are absolutely worth your time, so make sure to go through them. If you like this video, please give it a big fat thumbs up. Also, comment down below what kind of bookish content do you wish to see next. Till then, happy reading!